He used to work for LA County.
Oh, okay.
And then retired, so he came back.
Okay.
But he used to live here.
He went to Rogers.
When
I first moved here, these houses were pretty much nice there.
How are you?
Good.
How are you doing?
This is my friend the priest.
But whoever played against him, they were great.
All right, good afternoon. Can everybody hear me?
Yay!
I am so thankful that it is not a downpour today. I know, no kidding. We were wondering, like, well, we could try real hard to social distance. In any case, welcome. My name is Michelle Girardo. I'm the CEO of Habitat for Humanity Spokane, and welcome to our dedication celebration. People in this community and all over the world partner with Habitat for Humanity to build or improve a place that they can call home. Habitat homeowners help build their homes alongside volunteers and pay an affordable mortgage. And with our help and your help, Habitat homeowners achieve the strength, stability, and self-reliance they need to build a better life for themselves and their families. Habitat for Humanity seeks to put God's love into action by bringing people together to build homes, communities, and hope. And we believe in a world where everyone has a decent place to live. And it is through shelter we are able to help. So this home dedication ceremony commemorates the 353rd and 354th Habitat homes here in Spokane County.
Yay!
We're on our way to 400. We're proud to celebrate these two families, the Whitakers and the Gabrenicuses. And the Brennicus. And then remind me how else. This is a really exciting time, and I know that these two families have been working really hard and waiting a very long time for this day. The rehabilitation of these homes would not be possible without the support of the City of Spokane's Community Development Block Grant and our Shared Equity Housing and Homeownership Program. We also recognize the incredible partnership with Banner Bank. Banner Bank is one of our preferred lenders that assists families in getting across the finish line through their first mortgage. Additionally, we recognize the voices and advocacy of the West Central neighborhood residents and the amazing hearts and hammers of Habitat volunteers. Thank you for all of your help in revitalizing homes like these and others in West Central. So the completed homes you see here today are a testament to our community's generosity, resilience, and creativity. These homes weren't always on these lots. They were moved across the neighborhood. But they were also empty and abandoned and unloved. Now they will be filled with laughter, play, memories, and traditions. And we know there are a lot of families in this community, just like the families here today, that have yet to achieve the comfort and safety a home can bring. However, today is a testament to the Whitaker family and to Elsa and Abra Haley's family, who have completed their partnership requirements and will accept the keys to their new homes. So, I'm so sorry, my glasses are off because they were fogging up. And so all I see are some blurs, but if you are a Habitat board member or staff member, please raise your hand. Stories before we move along and do a blessing of the homes and hopefully accept the keys to these new homes. Yes. So who wants to start? Rock, paper, scissors?
Yeah, thank you for everything that
this home for us. He went before us every step of the way, and we're grateful. My kids are young, so they weren't able to really partner with Habitat, but they did partner through the whole journey. Every single night, faithfully, they prayed for a house with a yard and a slide, and God answered not only our prayers, but he answered our kids' prayers. So this house for us is an incredible blessing, and we also got to see the house from start to finish. And when you started, it wasn't much. It looked pretty hopeless. And a part of our testimony is that we've been through a lot of challenges, a lot of obstacles, and there's that time where it looked like it was hopeless. But God has restored our marriage, he's restored our family, and so this house for us is symbolic a lot of our journey, where it looked hopeless, but through the power of God, our family has been restored, and just like this house has been restored, so for us, it's kind of like a new beginning, and we're grateful for the opportunity, and we're grateful for everybody who's donated to Habitat to make this a possibility for our family, and we're grateful for all the volunteers, which I can see some of them today, like Tony and Linda and Kirsten. You guys put so much work into our house, and just above and beyond that, just the kindness and generosity. It was such a joy to be able to build our home alongside such incredible people who really love people and God, and you know, they invested so much into our home, and we're so grateful for everything that you guys have done. So thank you.
Thank you. All right, I'd like to invite Tony and Colleen up. Tony is a previous Habitat construction supervisor, and Tony is going to provide the families a Bible.
What a blessing.
As our means of demonstrating the love of Jesus to those who lack a decent place to live. Unapologetically Christian and radically inclusive, we value all people and we welcome everyone to this powerful work. Following the model of a perfect love shown to us in Jesus, we seek to live out our faith in a way that is liberating, not limiting. With that, let us pray over these families and their new homes. From our dreams, our faith, and our hard work, these houses become a reality. It began in a stirring in our hearts and is now a beacon of God's love. We fashioned our plans and we built these walls, and we pray that the spirit of God's love will surround this place. Family and friends will gather for joyous times in these rooms, and they will build memories of home as they share God's love. Over the years, the Whitaker and the Hallam Marion families will know good times and challenging times. We pray that God's love will sustain them, and we humbly ask God's blessing on this new home and trust that God will guide their hearts and minds of this family to create a home filled with love, hope, and joy. Oh Lord, be with these families as they fill these walls, creating from boards and nails a home. Guide their hearts and minds toward creating a home filled with love and joy. A house with foundations that are strong, resting on hope for the future and confidence in the reverence of life. And may the sweat, and the laughter, and the labor of all who helped in creating these homes strengthen and support it, as well as all who dwell here, and lead us to create a world where every person has a safe, decent place to call home, where justice is the central pillar and where equality is the shelter's roof. Yes. We pray in the sight of all that is holy. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
That concludes our home dedication. Congratulations to both of you. I know we're going to do some tours and some with some small groups, but please, you know, come close, come congratulate the family, and welcome home, you guys.
Are you going to make it the families over there?
Todd, you
want to
go right here? Did I meet you the first day you were on site?
Can you just put on the booties for me, the little blue booties, if you don't mind? The little blue booties off on the outside of the door, if you don't mind? Yeah, just go and put those on, you're good. That's okay, you can leave it on.
Is mom and dad down?
I think it might be upstairs. Hey. Okay, folks, just go ahead and please wait. We have to wait just for social distancing purposes. Just give me 1 second, please, okay? Okay. This is slightly problematic. Hi. 1 second, guys. Carly, I need you to moderate this door. I need you to stay here and guard the door. We can't let people go in without booties. I think we're out of booties.
Oh no, I'm totally fine with slipping these down. I've got to come on. Easy, easy, don't do.
She's right. A realtor, so she does.
All right.
So nice.
Okay. There's only like two people on anymore, but that's okay. All right. Thanks. And that's it. Thanks for joining us, everybody.